Good morning and welcome to this assembly for Monday the 25th of January 2021. Don't judge me, you might have said that recently or you might have heard it said by somebody else. And today I'm going to talk about judging others. I'm going to return to some well-known words from the Sermon on the Mount, and again, you might recognise them. Judge not that you be not judged, for with what judgment you judge, you will be judged. With what measure you use, it will be measured back to you. And why do you look at the speck in your brother's eye, but do not consider the plank in your own eye? Or how can you say to your brother, let me remove the speck from your eye, and look, a plank's in your own eye? Hypocrite, first remove the plank from your own eye, and then you will see clearly to remove the speck from your brother's eye. There are two key messages here. The first one is don't judge, and the second one is don't be a hypocrite. They're really two sides of the one coin, and teach us a lot about how we see ourselves and how we see other people, and how we treat ourselves and how we treat other people. Let's think about what we don't mean, first of all, when we say don't judge. We're not talking about turning off our critical faculties or not calling out bad behaviour where we see it. We absolutely must do those things. But what we are saying is that we shouldn't be censorious or judgmental. We shouldn't be fault finders or people who adopt a negative and destructive attitude towards other people. This can be difficult. During this pandemic, you often hear people complaining about crowded places like forest parks, seemingly unaware that they're contributing to the crowds by being there themselves. And people are quite content to blame others for breaking lockdown rules, but give themselves a bye ball when it comes to the rules that they're prepared to bend for their own convenience. That's where the next parable comes in, the well-known story of the speck of dust, or the mote in old-fashioned English, and the plank. It's a ludicrous image, and the humour is intentional. What it illustrates is the problem of hypocrisy, which comes about when we judge others but are blind to our own faults. And the good thing about being a hypocrite, as they say, is that you can continue to denounce hypocrisy. The fact that we're keen to find fault in others and that we're equally prone to overlooking our own shortcomings can lead to arrogance and an unpleasant sense of superiority. It can also indicate a lack of self-awareness, which does as little for relationships as it does for our development as individuals. Hypocrisy is the ugliest form of self-deceit. Worse still, this smug self-congratulation makes us vulnerable to going astray ourselves. So next time you're tempted to jump on some social media bandwagon condemning someone else's indiscretions, think again. Perhaps it's only a matter of grace that you're not the one being shamed. Being judgmental harms other people, but when we have the humility to realise that we're not perfect ourselves, that humility will enable us to help others and can gently assist them to remove the speck of dust from their eyes. Instead of judging other people, we should take a little time to examine ourselves and think about how we are living our lives. After all, by and large, the only person for whose behaviour we're responsible is our own. And for those of us, teachers or parents, who do have a role in regulating the behaviour of others, the responsibility is even greater. You'll be a long time searching for a perfect teacher or a perfect parent. All we can do is try our best, and with humility, remember our own shortcomings. But the lesson is the same for each one of us. We need to get our own house in order before we start trying to sort things out for other people. Don't try to remove the mote in somebody else's eye when there's a huge beam sticking out of yours. Now, there's a challenge. Well, thanks again for tuning in to this week's assembly. Hope everybody's had a good weekend and that you're ready for the week ahead. We've now had 3 weeks of remote learning, so we're halfway to half term. We don't know exactly what implication the extended lockdown will have for the closure of schools, but we'll have further information on that this week and we'll let you know as soon as it comes through. We're also expecting an update on the awarding of qualifications at GCSE, AS and A2. And again, once we have that information in school, we'll pass it on to you. Please do let us know if you're struggling with anything or if there's any assistance you require. We have some SIM cards in school now as well for people who require extra data, and those can be made available to you on request. I've sent out a letter to parents about that. That's everything that I have to say for today. Have a good week, and I hope everything goes well for you.